Okay, so if you look at this, this is a humerus, and this would be a left humerus. And the way that I know that's a left is I look at the head and I know that that's pointed medially. Then I think in the anatomical position, okay, and that's going to articulate with the glenoid cavity. So here's the greater tubercle, lesser tubercle, intertubercular groove, deltoid tuberosity, and then here's the medial epicondyle and the lateral epicondyle. And what I want to know is this is the capitulum, which articulates with the radius. So there's a radial fossa right there. There's a coronoid fossa, and then that would be the trochlea right here. Okay, and the trochlea will articulate with the ulna. Okay, so if I turn it over, then I see that the posterior view is shiny, and I have an olecranon fossa right here. So again, making sure that you know right and left, but try to orient the head of the humerus first, and then the medial epicondyle, and that will help you. But first of all, just figure out that it's a humerus before you start to study the little things on there. So again, head of the humerus, anatomical neck. Surgical neck is where most fractures occur here. Here's the shaft, here's the deltoid tuberosity. Here is the capitulum, trochlea, coronoid fossa here, and the radial fossa and medial epicondyle.